Hello everybody, hope you're all doing fantastic today. In this video, I'm going to go over some of my images and then review them. So it's basically my own photo review, and that's why the title is MOPR, so my own photo review. This is episode 2. I have done an episode 1. If you want to go check it out there, I'll link it above. And let's get right into the first image. So the first image on the screen here is an image I took with my phone, and it was taken on a farm about 30 minutes of driving away from where I live, and it was taken on the mountain while we were driving there. I was actually driving while taking this image. I didn't even look when I took it. I just held the phone up and just took a bunch of images. And that's why the tree is a little bit close, too close to the right edge, too close for my taste, but I'm satisfied with how it came out. It's a decent image. I would give it a, 3 out of 5 maybe. For my standard, maybe even lower. So, just meaning it's, for the image I want to take, this is maybe a 2 out of 5. It's not up there. Maybe a 3 out of 5. It's not that bad. It's just representing the average Eastern Cape mountain, which is like Sierveld, which is like dry grass almost on top. And then there's a line almost, or in most cases where I live, the mountains have this grass on top. And then there's a solid line where the bush starts. I don't know if it's around the world if that's also the case, but especially here where I live, that is definitely the case. And you can see this right there. The bush, well, this is not so clear, but the bushes start at the line, and then on top of the mountain there's just this grass. But I think it just represents, the mountains where I live. This image just represents that. Hey, just to pause for a bit, if you like my video, please go down and like it. If you want to see more of my videos, please go down and subscribe. And if you feel like you have a friend that might find it useful, please share this video. Let's continue. Then I have the next shot that I also took on that occasion that we went to the farm. And I really like this image. We were driving, and me and my sister were back on the back of the bucky or truck in America, or whatever the thing with the whatever you can put something on the back. We were sitting on the back and we were driving, and I saw that moon just went very close. This was, we were in the valley, and this was the land inside this image were just the edge of the top of the mountain. And so we were driving, and I was like, okay, that tree just went very close to this moon. And I'm like, oh, that would make a great shot. And so I stopped my dad and said, okay, let's go back just 100 meters and just, I want to go take that image. So we stopped, and I walked a bit into, just to get the moon, down enough into the image to just sit behind this tree. And I took about 10 photos, I think, firing it off. And this was the only one that was sharp. Really, I was like, this was close. I didn't realize it until I came home and just, look at the images. I think it's framed correctly, and it's because the moon and the tree adds visual weight to the right side of the image. And then to counter that, or just to balance that out, an image has to have balance. So, the rule of thirds is the basic rule, but it's kind of not that great composition sometimes if it's only this thing on the right hand side and nothing left to just balance the image out visually. And so I think this was framed correctly. I could have framed it with the tree on the and the moon on the left side and higher. But why I think this is so cool and good is because I framed the tree and the moon on the right side, where the mountain, where the piece of land is a little bit less the size, where on the left hand side of the image there's a much bigger piece of you know, mountain with interesting visual stuff, like nice trees and, you know, aloes and I'm not sure what they're called in English. I like how that visual weight on the left hand side of the mountain just balances out the main subject on the right hand side. And then I also love this tree, how the just late sunset light just falls down onto this trees. I really think it just makes the image. If I took it on any other time of the day, it wouldn't have been, you know, just this well nice looking. Then the next one I took also with my phone. I did have my camera there, I think. But at that time I didn't feel like, you know, doing anything with my camera. So I just took my phone and said like, this could, you know, look kind of nice. So I took the image and right there edited it. And I think it turned out great. I love the composition. Once again, the tree I think is the main subject. And then your eyes, you know, just after that looks at this road. And then it comes down and you look at this interesting grass. It was, you know, very misty as you can see. And I tinted it a little bit blue. And I think it just, you know, it came out very good. I would give this image, because I'm not really a landscape photographer and this was taken with a phone, I'd give this a 4 out of 5. It's a 4 out of 5 for me. The next one, you know, did not follow rule of thirds, and you can sometimes break the rule. And as you can see, I framed this heron right in the middle of the image. And that bird is bright because the sun was shining on it and it was bright. So that's why the rest of the image is so dark. I didn't make it darker. It's really because I dropped the exposure enough to not clip the heron's feathers. You know, the rest of the image turned out nice and dark, which I really like. And I don't think I added vignetting, but I didn't remove the lens's vignetting. So it frames the bird very nice. And just once again, just to throw off that balance a bit, because my subject is in the center now, just something to give it a little bit of I'll just put the word on the screen. Priority, I think is the correct word. Just to give one side a little bit of visual priority, the heron didn't look straight at me. You know, it's looking to one side. And that just, I think, just breaks that perfect balance that this shot gives. Because really there's nothing different on the left and on the right in this image. So just that heron looking just to the one side, just, I think, just breaks that symmetry. Just, you know, making it, I think, a better image. Not an incredible image, but I think it's, you know, it's a decent, it's a nice image. The next one I took also at the Sunrise River mouth, and this was taken just, you know, a little bit of after sunset. You can see the sun still there. There's Jupiter and Saturn, you know, it's a long exposure, so you can see them moving. And there's also a plane flying there. That I don't know, is it a good thing or a bad thing, but I like it. It just adds something, pointing you to Jupiter and Saturn that just set. And I can't remember, okay, who's hooting now? I can't remember there was some occasion, I think it's, no, it's not, maybe it's the closest that Jupiter and Saturn got. It's just a few days before this image was taken. And there you can see the sand dunes and the river. And you can see these streams where the water flows very fast compared to other spots where, you know, it's standing still. So I like the shot. I think it's quite interesting. What I now don't like is, you know, the dunes is right in the center of the frame vertically, and that's not great. Then finally, I think this is a Goliath heron. It's not that amazing image. because it's too simple. It's just a portrait. So I want to make a video on, we should not try to capture just portraits, but rather try to capture emotion and, you know, movement and yeah. So it's not a great image, but it's decent. It's a nice portrait. Yeah. So I think, yes, that's my photo review for today. And it's starting to rain now and I have to get home. Okay guys, I hope you've learned something from this video. I'm sorry it's raining now, so I'm at home and trying to film here. I hope you've learned something from the video, being able to catch a few tips on how to compose images. And yes, thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Have fun shooting.